Welcome to aroundBI. This tutorial is continuum of our discussion on dimensions and facts. We are talking about types of dimensions, and conformed dimension is an important one. It is widely used in data warehouse designs. We will discuss about what is conformed dimension and its advantages in data warehouse. But before that, let's talk about a practical scenario to understand why do we need anything called conformed dimension. I have selected few tables as a sample in test database. We have two subject areas, HR and finance. For both subjects, we have separate data marts that has a fact table in each. Let's call HR fact and finance fact. HR fact is associated with employee and time dimension tables, whereas finance fact is associated with time and product dimension table. Even if we consider these data marts very discrete, from the structure point of view, we can see some common elements like time dimension. It is common to both subjects. This time dimension may be calculated differently. For example, finance may refer year dimension as budget year and HR will call it calendar year. Or finance uses Monday to Sunday as a week, whereas HR team considers Sunday to Saturday as a week. My point here is to estimate what is cost associated in maintaining multiple copies of dimensions that are very much identical in nature. Now I have two options to maintain separate copies of these tables. I can either keep these tables distinctly, that will have unique meaning and definition to a data mart like budget year for finance and calendar year for HR, but that will bring cost of maintenance, more ETL work and possible difficulty in joining multiple data marts. With my second option, I could rather modify these dimensions to a form that has same meaning to every fact wherever it relates. In that way, it will conform same rule and same definitions everywhere. And that is the concept of conformed dimension. A conformed dimension is a type of dimension that has same meaning to every fact with which it relates in data warehouse. If we come back to our example, these two time dimensions will be called conformed if they have exactly the same description and content, or one is a subset of another when we refer to separate fact tables. We can either call both of them as calendar year and use in data marts, or for simplicity we can copy to two separate conformed dimensions and call one as budget year and other as calendar year. Though it has two separate names, but underlying table is same. Similar way, we can define a common logic for dimension week and use in data warehouse. While creating a conformed dimension, we just have to make sure that there cannot be any other type of difference between the two tables. Even if their primary key is different, they will not be called conformed. That is the definition of conformed dimension. But let's talk about benefits that make conformed dimensions so important. Since conformed dimensions have same description and definition to every fact with which it relates in data warehouse, it guarantees consistent reporting across the organization. It can become single source of information for a dimension that can be reused across projects. Once these dimensions are available, developers can reuse existing conformed dimensions, and that will turn faster development. If we need to modify any dimensional attributes with conformed dimensions, process will be easier and less complex rather than modifying different versions of a dimensions. Even for ETL development, they will focus on developing more fact tables as the associated dimension tables are already ready to use. It makes the whole ETL process more efficient as it does not have to do multiple procedures to process the same dimension related data. On the same note, if we talk about characteristics of data warehouse, one of the key nature of warehouse should be integrity. That says that there must be a single version of entity once the data flows into the warehouse. And definition of conformed dimension is very much aligned with integrity. As with it, we try to preserve single description of a dimension throughout organization. Other big benefit of using conformed dimension is its use as bridge between multiple data marts. Data warehouse guru Ralph Kimball has defined conformed dimension as a descriptive master reference data that is referenced in multiple dimensional models. In that way, information from separate fact tables can be combined to a single report by using conformed dimension attributes that are associated with each fact table. In that case, it becomes a medium of integration between multiple business processes. Users can navigate from multiple business processes, data sources. For example, a dashboard can be created from more than one fact table, and this is possible when there is a conformed dimension between the fact tables. We have seen time dimension as a conformed dimension in our example. That is very common conformed dimension used in warehouse. Other examples could be customer dimension. Customers from sales and customer from partners can be conformed and used to link both areas. If we talk about healthcare industry, patient dimension could be a good candidate for conformed dimension. It will bridge clinical information and financial planning information together. This is all about conformed dimension. I am a big supporter of building conformed dimensions in data warehouse designs. It avoids a lot of design issues and help users to slice and dice against multiple subject areas. Please share how you are using conformed dimensions in your organizations. We would be very happy to get your feedback and comments. Thanks for watching.